We've definitely done a lot of bootstrapping. I've eaten plenty of ramen noodles, and I've slept on plenty of couches. So that's part of it, but that's kind of the Hollywood version of it.
I knew in my heart of hearts that I've always wanted to run my own business, you know, build something from scratch.
We only stepped away from this bootstrapping model because we had, you know, giant ambitions. At some point, if you have a really big ambition, you need to put the resources behind it.
You're gonna get up every day and you're gonna try to rally other people around your idea. You gotta be passionate about it. You really have to believe that you have the potential to change the world.
Go out and do something massively impactful. Otherwise, like, why waste the time?
People define startups as technology companies almost exclusively. I'm not sure that's exactly right.
Doing a startup takes up more than all of your time, and that's to get that 1% chance that you might be able to succeed.
I have not worked for two coming up on 3 years. I don't really think about it as so much of a sacrifice as it is an investment into the future.
This is my first foray into kind of the entrepreneurial world. But until you actually take that plunge, you don't realize whatever you assume, it's 10 times tougher than that.
15 years ago, everybody wanted to be Bill Gates. Now they all want to be Mark Zuckerberg. And the reality is running a company is not that easy, and it's often not that fun.
Accelerators change your nightmares. I'm still losing sleep, but they're more manageable now.
We're trying to accelerate kind of 12, 15 months of kind of typical startup inertia and pack it into 3 months. And in that pressure, things invariably break.
We have short attention spans, and we see things as overnight successes. And it's really easy to look at insert the blank startup and just assume there were no failures along the way.
Entrepreneurship is not a spectator sport. You have to do it. You have to be in the moment.